Good afternoon, friends. As promised to you, now I'm introducing the real domain of data mining, especially with the machine learning algorithms. And here, first of all, before I can begin, I would like to thank my mentors, Neeraj sir, Jason, Ayan, and there are others also, the list is very long, who introduced me to the domain of, I would say, machine learning and explained to me various things which are associated. And as a layperson, I was able to understand and try to grab the intricacies as well as the conceptual knowledge which is there for these things coming from the background. Now, I would like to mention even Siddharth also side by side because he was again one of the person who really made me understand what is the importance of purchasing the softwares and rather than just relying on the free sources which are available. Though I'm not against it, I love R, I love Python, and the way the things are taking place in those particular domains. However, for the presentation sakes as well as for the I would say for the analysis, there are other tools also which are available, and one of them is the mind map. To create awesome mind maps for ourselves. So here I'm taking you through right now the domain of machine learning algorithms, and you can see the first, this is the main one that I wanted to focus on, and let's see how many are going to be there for these algorithms. So I have got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 of them are present. So you can understand how many varieties of algorithms are present for me and how am I supposed to use them in my own analysis, especially with the help, which comprises of the data mining. So first and foremost is I have got Bayesian ones, which is very popular kind of I would say the algorithms which are present in machine learning. Under Bayesian, I can just showcase to you, and we should be able to understand them. For example, naive bias, then averaged one dependence estimator, that is AODE, Bayesian belief network, Gaussian naive bias, multinomial, and Bayesian network BN. So this is just one category. My favorite is decision trees because it's very simple and very nice, and there's no rocket science over there. And Excel Stat as well as I would say MaxQDA, and there are this I mean the softwares like R and Python really focus on decision trees, and we will see how to proceed further. And here we have got the terminologies, like that's why I said through data mining you are going to be introduced to a lot of jargon, which is jargon in the sense I'm not saying these are waste kind of a thing, however you will be inculcating in your own research areas. So one of them is classification and regression tree, iterative dichotomizer tree, that is ID3, C4.5, C5.0, chi-squared. I mean, when I was introduced, I was just wondering, what is this chi, turf analysis, key driver analysis, all these things. However, the moment I started learning, I understood why understanding that data is really important. So these are some of the techniques. Then you have got decision stump, the conditional decision trees, then you have got M5. Now similarly, I was introduced to factor analysis, which each one of us are aware of it. However, if I take over and come to data mining, they don't talk about what I call it as factor analysis. They have differentiated between what they call it as dimensionality reduction. Number one, you can pronounce it dimensionality reduction or dimensionality. Now there are some people who pronounce it as dimensions, and so others are there who pronounce at dimension. So dimensionality reduction is there. Under this itself, I have seen factor analysis and exploratory dimension analysis or dimensionality analysis, and then the other words that you will see especially in the domain of R, Python, and the other softwares that I was talking about. So under dimensionality, and you will understand why they are not using the word factors and they are using the word dimensions, okay, and how the reduction is taking place, and we are not deriving or arriving at, however, we are reducing them. That is the word that they are going, and you will see. So under this, I have got principal component analysis, PCA. We all know in factor analysis, we are introduced to it. Then we have got the popular partial least squares regression, PLSR. I would say the smart PLS is the one that we are talking about. So here you will understand that also. Salmon mapping, multidimensional scaling, MDS. Now through Neeraj sir, I was introduced to MDS, I would say. However, going forward, here you will see that it is not just MDS. There are other branches for it, and once I'll be reaching, and it's a separately playlist of mine, immediately I'm going to upload it. Have a look at it and you will understand why MDS in data mining. Then comes projection pursuit. Then we have got principal component regression. So principal component analysis is very different, that is PCA, and we have got what we call it as PCR. Now this is not the police van I'm talking about, this is the principal component regression. Then we have got here partial least squares regression. Comparatively, we have got partial least squares discriminant analysis. So can you see that for partial least squares itself, regression is also there, discriminant analysis is also present. Mixture discriminant analysis, MDA, quadratic discriminant, then we have got regularized, flexible, and linear discriminant analysis. So you can see how many discriminations are coming in through dimensionality reduction. So these are the ones which really grabbed my attention, and I dedicated myself learning about these things so that I myself can go ahead before I can apply even the concepts of, let's say, correlation, covariance, or SEM, or even model testing. So I thought, let me go ahead and complete with these, and then I'm going to, not that I don't know about them, however, these ones really helped me to understand more and more. And now you will see the next one that you can find it out is basically for the instance based. Now, under this, we have got the concepts of K nearest neighbor, KNN, learning vector quantization, then self-organizing map. I mean, it's such a beautiful visualization that you can understand your own data which is present. Then locally weighted learning is one more thing that really helps me, and I really love it. Now, similarly, you can go ahead and, you know, you can check it out with clustering also. So here, clustering. You can see K means is there, K median. So they are going to focus on taking the mean value and working on it, taking the medians and then proceeding further. Similarly, expectation maximization. You will, once you will understand these terminologies, the concepts behind it, the knowledge behind these things, you will really understand why clustering as a separate topic in data mining. Similarly, hierarchical clustering. Now, this is again very interesting one. And I really understood what is taking place. My favorite area, regression, linear regression, ordinary least squares regression, stepwise regression, multivariate adaptive regression, splines. Now, this is MARS, that is they're going to call it as, or LOIS. Now, if you do it in R or Python, these things really are making it very clear, and you can see the stories which are being shared with help of your own data. Then I have got the logistic regression. It is not just going ahead and using your software and coming over. Try to understand again the data that is being used for the logistic regression, and you will be able to learn them. Similarly, rules. Rules really is a I would say another domain in data mining which I would say really helped me to understand certain things like Q-based, one rule, zero rule are there. And you will see that with your own data, sometimes you get 12 rules, 23 rules. And the moment you understand what these rules are, you can proceed further. Similarly, we have got repeated incremental pruning.
to produce error reduction, which is called as RIPR, ripping your data. That's what we say. Here we are trying to reduce the errors. So what does that mean? Try to understand. Neeraj sir keeps on talking about errors which are existing. CP Gupta sir talks about the importance of the errors, the noise which is present. However, here, can I go ahead and really reduce the error, the noise which is present in my data? So how is it going to take place is what you're going to learn. Regularization is one more area which I really, again, if you are found of different kind of regressions, till date I have found around 68. And when I told Neeraj sir, there are 68 varieties of regression and I have just know only 4 or 5 of them, you know, he gave me a big smile. So, you know, as you are entering into the domain of machine learning or artificial intelligence or simple analysis also, you will find that yes, these regressions are available. For example, I have got ridge regression, then lasso, which is very important, least absolute shrinkage and selection operator. When I was introduced, I was just thinking cowboy and lassos. No, this has to do with least absolute. So just look, that's why I said these are the jargons, the communication that you can see through the data mining with help of machine learning. Then we have got least angle regression also. Neural networks, it really helps you a lot. If you are introduced to it, there's nothing for it. For example, you have got perceptron back propagation, then Hopf field network. And you will see when I would be introducing to you for the social network analysis or text analysis, which is really important, you would be able to understand. Then we have got what we call it as ensemble. This is different kind of a thing. If you are very fond of systematic literature review and meta-analysis, most of you must have heard there is something called as random forest plots. Now we use those softwares or the I would say the tools without understanding what exactly is random forest. Now why random forest for our own readings or the publications that we have selected or we are going to you know, take away, exclude or include them. So you will understand the concept of random forest with help of the machine learning algorithms which will be helping you. Then we have got what we call it as the gradient boosting machines. These are okay, I won't talk much about it right now. As the concepts are coming in, we would be going ahead and I'll be showing to you bootstrapped aggregation, which is called as bagging. Now for the first time in my life, I understood what is the concept of bootstrapping and why we are doing it, why we have to divide our data, let's say for 500 or 5000 or 10,000, and then we are proceeding further. This you will understand with help of the data mining concept. ADA boosting is also there. Then stack generalization, which is blending, gradient boosted regression trees, radial. So now you understood why data mining through machine learning has grabbed my attention and I was entering into it. Similarly for the deep learning, here we have got DBM, which stands for deep Boltzmann machine. So please don't get scared. If a person like me can learn about these things and get introduced to it and use them in my own research work, trust me, even each one of you can take care of these things. Deep belief networks, then we have got convolutional neural networks. I mean, we don't use the words, the full form of it, you know, we go ahead and now I'm so used to it that I keep talking about DBM, DBN, CNN, CBN, neural networks is NN, then PCA, then I have got SHAD, then I have got TURF analysis. If I tell you about all these things, I was wondering you know, which era I am in. And if you know the basics of the research methodology, these takes you to the next level and you are able to understand. And this is the reason why I said now I have to come to that level wherein I can introduce the machine learning algorithm and understand how to go further with the statistical analysis for your own research work. So this is just a brief mind map that I
have been shared with one of my mentors, and you know, I thank the person also for it. And you know, we will be learning all these things, and we will see how to learn them, how to use them, what kind of a coding. When I say the coding, I'm talking about the scripts, which is very easy in R or Python, or without these things also there are softwares which with just the clicks with your fingers you can proceed further also side by side. So this is just a small introduction. So I'm giving you a window shopping for the machine learning algorithms which is presented to you right now, and going further we would be entering into each one of them and we will work out. Sometimes I might take some ready-made I would say like some of the softwares, like just like SPSS gives you the leverage for various kind of samples of the data when you are purchasing it. Similarly, some of these softwares have given us the leverage with the data also. So I can use that data for my own training purposes or demo purposes, or we can then we can go ahead and we can use them with our own data also. So with this introduction to algorithms, I welcome each one of you, and let me proceed further in my next video about each one of these, and we will be understanding them. Thank you for watching, and I'll just catch you up again in my next video with these each one of these algorithms. Thank you. Bye. Take care.